And welcome back to Drawing with your girl, Amazing Fit. Today, we are going to be doing an art supply haul. I know, I'm so excited. It was recently my birthday, and I'm really excited because, you know, I have a bunch of new stuff, so I'm going to be doing an art supply haul, and this is, like, literally all the stuff, so it's surrounding me. It's a little messy and hard to understand, but whatever. So, the first thing is this pack of Skin Toned Touch 5 alcohol-based ink markers for the fine touch sketch, and I think that these are going to work super well. These look, I kind of tried to open the packaging already, but, you know, it's fine. The packaging is just amazing. Like, they look like they actually were trying to make this super, 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 like, tight and make sure nothing happened to them. I actually did get, like, a second pack. I don't know if that was a mistake or not, but they are the same colors in here, just differently organized and placed, so, yeah. Thing I have is 6 of these little paint palettes, and I'm really, really, really happy with these because they are just really good for swing, like, just to go, you know. But paint palettes generally aren't that big, so obviously you can bring them anywhere, but these are just, like, literally fit in your pocket. If you need a paintbrush, it's in your pocket too. You have it on the go. And I think these are super, super good because they can fit 6 colors in here. And I believe there are 6 of them. Yes, there are 6 of them. So 6 palettes that have 6 spaces in each of them, which is just great. Up, we have these sponge paintbrushes, or not really paintbrushes, but sponge brush sets. Open these up. So these look really nice. I actually am pretty happy about that because the one I have is broken and there's paint on it, acrylic paint, so it doesn't work the way it's supposed to. And then I have another one and that broke off, so it doesn't go back together. I'm really happy that I have these now, and I have a wide variety, and that is very, very helpful if I'm trying to get up a big space, or I just want a tiny space so I don't get it everywhere. So these are super, super good, and I'm really happy about them. Next thing we have is 6 of these mini canvases, and now I'm really, really happy with these because mini canvases, some people are like, no, I want a big space to work on, and I feel like it's just worth it in the end. But actually, I packed one. So I had another one, but I packed it for Florida. So yeah, I really am happy with 6 canvases because it's not, like, a lot, and I don't need, like, super big canvases, and sometimes little canvases are generally better. This is what I could create with 6 canvas. This is what I created with a mini canvas. This was inspired by Doodle Your Noodles, and she did this and I absolutely loved it, so I did it with marker, and that's what I did on a mini canvas, and I think it's really, really cool. So I'm really happy with this. I also did Super Ray Dizzle, which is one of my favorite artists, and I did her profile. Not really a profile, but because that's kind of the side of you, but anyway, this is what I did of her. It technically does not look exactly like her, but I still really like how it came out. So I'm super, super excited about these mini canvases. I don't have a place for canvases, but I do now, so. I do have this panel canvas. I have actually a second one too that I got. These are 5x7, and these are super, super good too. And you can see the ring light, but whoa. I'm really happy that I have this because they look just, they're good to use because they're flat and they're just nice, and I feel like they work very well. So I'm really happy that about the next one thing I got. It's not like a high quality, super expensive thing. I really actually am happy about this sketchbook, which I was like, what should I call it? It has very thin paper, but I think it'll be good for just sketches and planning, and I really am happy with this. And I think it'll be super cool to actually paint the cover, so it'll be just, you know, cool.
It's on the floor with the canvases because I'm like so used to doing that because I, well, not used to, but just I've been doing that recently more.
So yeah. I also have this big watercolor palette from XL Kansan, which you know I love because you can see it right here. That's my other one, and I'm really happy because this is such a good brand. It's such a good brand, and I feel like this is something I'm gonna need. I actually started to run out of watercolor, and I was like, oh, I love watercolor, but now I have a new pad to use for watercolor, and it is a very good size. It's almost like a canvas because you honestly don't need to use watercolor on watercolor paper because acrylic works really well too, but I like to stay on topic, so yeah. All right, so moving along, I got these wonders. Oh shoot, they're spilling. No, this is what I was afraid of. These These Faber-Castell Gold Faber colored pencils, and I'm so, so, so excited about these. They are so nice, and I've always wanted Faber-Castell colored pencils. Faber-Castell is a top pencil brand in the world. Like, they literally are the best colored pencils. They're the best brand for, I think, personally for me, they are the best brand for colored pencils, erasers, just regular, like, pencils in the world. And I'm really, really happy about these. There's 48 in here, and they look beautiful. And I actually, these are my first real, very professional colored pencils. The only colored pencils I've ever used for, like, more, like, detailed art. Like, I use watercolor pencils. I don't have, like, colored pencils that, you know, you do very, like, I don't know how to explain it, but just, like, detailed stuff with. The only colored pencils that are real colored pencils, no watercolor anything in them, would be like the ones that I've had since I was 3. So yeah,
they're awesome, and I'm so excited to use these. So
yeah. Next up, we have these paintbrushes. These are super, 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 sorry. These are super cool paintbrushes. These look super bad and cheap and terrible, but they actually, I think, are gonna work really well. And I'm really excited to use these because they have a good variety and just the different kinds of paintbrushes look really well made. And I don't even know what the price was for this, but like they don't look like they're plastic bristles or fibers, so that is a good sign.
Okay, so then I have Hallelujah Grand White Paint, and every artist will need that because if they don't, they will die.
Because you won't survive. The basics. These are actually all the same brand, and they're the exact same kind, except two of them have different packaging. I don't understand why, but you know, who cares? It's still paint. It doesn't matter what the packaging looks like. It's about what's on the inside, and that's literally what you have to do for everything. It's like, oh yeah, she's so like a human. Like, for example, maybe the outside doesn't look good, but the inside is beautiful. So unless it's the other way around, so it's like, oh yeah, I'm so beautiful and I'm like so bratty on the inside. I don't know. But yeah, these I'm really, really, really happy with because I've actually wanted just tubes of basic paint because, you know, they're what mix colors with them, and they really just help a lot. And I'm also really excited that I have black and white just because you just can't live without it. And plus, I have not just like tube of white paint. It's a dream.
So then, I believe the last thing I have
is this wondrous paint palette. This is like, actually, this is like my first like true paint palette that is shaped in like a paint palette that everyone thinks looks like, because I have had Uzis for a very long time now, and now I have this. So yeah, it doesn't have like, I've seen a bunch of people like, well, actually just one people, I'm sorry if I'm singling you out, but Mariah Elizabeth, one of my favorite artists too, she always used, I don't paint on paint palettes, I just don't find it, I find it so interesting and so cool, but I just like painting on something that I kind of would rather look at than use, because I just like using them more. But anyway, she paints on them, and there's like the certain kind that she buys that are just flat, and like when she mixes colors together and when she paints on them, she forgets to take the wrapper off, so then there's nothing there. But I kind of find a find that like good for me, because I don't paint on them, so it's like very clean paint palette when you're done.
So sad to say, that is my art haul that I have for y'all today. I'm really excited to use all of this stuff. I'm definitely going to do a review like on the Faber-Castell, these like the Touch 10 markers. So yeah, I really hope Kona's panting upstairs. So yeah, that is my art haul for today. I'm super, super excited to use all this stuff, and I hope you have a fantastic day. So, bye!